feel about him. But anyways, we're going to go right into the first match. We are in the open stage. There are no walls here. And let's start it off. So we have Peeling versus Speed Kicks. And as you can tell, he's not using Huarong here.
This is true.
So they're going to start off.
I told you, man, I'm psychic.
Here we go. Now, Peeling, probably very happy with how Xiao Yu is in this iteration of the game. She is a very strong character, and she really just fits the system more, I think. I know there's been a lot of debate whether or not she's really that good or not, but we'll see.
Yeah, but she's actually very, I think she's a lot stronger than she has been in previous iterations.
Yeah.
But we'll continue in here.
Okay. Great stuff. Able to get that quick poke damage, not letting her get into AOP for free. Oh, there was a whiff there. That could have been a huge launch. Doesn't matter. Speed Kick's playing very solid right now. All right. Caught him with the low. Oh!
Yeah.
Aaron Duck there. Not looking good. This could be it. No, not enough.
To me, that's like the biggest buff of her character right there. The AOP 4-3 to yeah. The down 4-2-1. Because if you try to move it all on the wake up, you will get launched.
You will get fully launched. Yeah, and that's such a great move in general, because if they just stay there, it still hits grounded, and that's been a staple since tag one. Okay. Now, Speedkick's doing a great job of just spacing overall, not really getting caught in the Ling BS.
Yeah.
Not getting put in the blender, so to speak. Oh, wow, that crouch dash one, able to hit very very hard on the floor there. Ooh, good stuff, and that should be able to close that out here. Oh, not enough.
And Speed Kicks is very familiar with Ling, you know, because I play him a lot. So, like, in this matchup, like, Peeling is going to have to do some interesting things to keep Steven on his toes.
Okay, gets him with a nice command grab. Let's see what the follow-up is. Oh, caught him right out of the air. Now, one of the real buffs that Jin has here is his standing four now. It's a very quick move that puts him into the screw state. And you'll probably see that with a lot of the combos that wasn't possible before. With Tekken 7, the removal of the overall bound system, you don't see bound using being the extender of combos. You don't see the tag assault combos, obviously, since it's a 1v1 game. You see the resurgence of a new combo extension, which is they're calling screw attacks.
Right.
And with the screw attacks, it's really something that like kind of knocks them further away, and then you can extend your combos. So for anyone that really likes to play the game and like carry characters to the wall and keep the wall pressure, it's great for that.
Yeah.
But there are some other system changes overall that have been impacted because of the different changes in the game. One of which, I think the biggest one, is Okizemi in general. There's like no brutal Okizemi. Like, you could hold back all day and you won't get relaunched, really.
Well, I don't know. Like, that
for most characters.
That's how you, AOP 4-3, that's brutal Okizemi. You know,
because you can extend combos from that.
Yeah.
But in general, like moves that used to pick up, they don't anymore. So
and the animation is different too, right? Like for they crawl backwards and get up.
Yeah, there's actually I think in general everyone has a different animation now, especially walking back.
Yeah.
That wasn't an animation that people had before, and I believe it was introduced in Tekken Revolution. That gonna hit in time? It does not, and that is a high move.
I'm Big Geo.
Yep, and we're gonna go right into this match.
Steven hailing from Atlanta, Georgia. Peeling hailing from somewhere in California.
I think he's right under NorCal. He's like in Central California.
Okay, SenCal. Yeah. That's interesting because there hasn't been a SenCal representative in a while.
Yeah.
As far as the community.
Well, that's the great thing. I mean, a lot of people, I think they know that he has really, his Tekken career has been born out of the online community. And there's a Jetstream skyrocket. Huge damage here from Speed Kicks. Did not get to the wall, but it doesn't matter. That was nice. 50% combo there. Oh, he hesitated there.
And then that's another buff in this game.
AOP 2-1.
AOP 2-1 is natural combo.
Natural combo, and against the wall, it is such a scary option. Because obviously, you know, Ling from AOP, she has a lot of great mid options.
Right.
And people don't really want to duck. I mean, if they do duck, they'll get hit by the 4-3, and that's just a knockdown. Not as scary as it was in past games because of the Oki. Right. But now, because of AOP 2-1, you got to be aware.
Right.
You got to be aware.
And with the overall nerf of movement.
And sidestep, like, yep.
Yeah, it makes that much more viable than it was in previous iterations.
Yeah, I think that is actually probably her biggest buff in the game is AOP 2-1, especially in those close confined situations.
Yeah,
oh, this is going to be big. Able to get that stun. Here's the follow-up. Pushes towards the wall. No, did not follow up. Could have had at least enough 4-3 plus 4
Jump
to extend
City.
It. Oh, caught him. and it's such a scary situation for Warang to be in. But
to wake up there.
And you notice Speedkick's playing very compact, not really using a lot of strings with Warang. That was a clutch low parry, and he's on the scoreboard. So one round apiece for these two.
Like Steven understands that Peeling is going to be going for the LP 4-3 a lot more because it's better in this game. So
yeah, he got him moving there. Oh, this is the wall. Mix-ups? Oh, my God. Forced him to guess there. He goes for a bound move, but hey, just enough. Now, to roll out of those moves that do those weird flips, like usually it happens with moves that used to bound,
right.
You have to hold back on the stick. And that's kind of unnatural for, you know, a Tekken game to do like a tech roll. So it's similar to like doing a quick pop-up from a violent knockdown.
Yeah.
But one of the things Warang players have to really be aware of is because of the new system and the Power Crush, you know, Power Crush being like able to crush or go through and absorb all mids and highs. A lot of Warang's strings are mostly mids and highs, and it's very rare that he actually has a low that extends into further pressure. I believe it's just left Flamingo down 3-4 and just down 3-4 in general.
And he has that stand switch to the right stance to the big low that launches?
Yes, that low, and then he just gets like a follow back three.
And I think also he has the right stance to the, it's like a down 4-4 maybe?
Yeah. Oh, his ghetto hell sweep.
Yeah, but it's guaranteed in this game.
It is.
Combo.
Okay, has him looking. That pressure goes for the Flamingo throw. Oh, this is going to be it. That should hurt. And speed kicks just swag.
I think it's 2 out of 3.
All right. Actually, that's kind of unfair considering Tag 2 was 3 out of 5.
Yeah.
I wonder what they're doing. I would assume it's 3 out of 5. But we'll see. We'll see if someone gets up.
We'll see.
But anyways, here we go. It's Peeling. Good pressure, and this is one of those stages that actually transforms. So once you get to the third round, it goes from a more open stage. So right now there are walls, but you'll see as the stage transitions throughout the gameplay. Okay, got a punish there. There you go. Great punish there from Speed Kicks, and that was natural combo. Oh, he caught him moving. Counter hit, just frame skyrocket. He's going to push towards the wall. Oh, he wanted the big damage here. He was going to go for the 4-3-1. Into the wall, rising 4-4, and that has guaranteed damage.
The ghetto hell sweep we were talking about.
That's right, the ghetto hell sweep.
But he just used the first hit and then went into back three because back three does hit on the ground in this game.
Yeah. And traditionally, that has been one of Huarang's best Oki tools is that back three. If they don't want to get up, they're going to hurt. Okay, nice. Gets that carry, pushing towards the wall, and now, wow, that interrupt right there. Oh! I respect that. He went for the punish. That's a very tight punish there with the back three. He had to crouch cancel first. Oh, wow. Hop kick. Just throwing it out. That should be it. And Speed Kick's doing a great job.
He's looking real confident right now.
Yeah.
He's being risky, but the moves that he's choosing to use is because he believes in the choices he's made.
Yeah, and several of those launchers were great options because just in case Ling went into AOP, it would have launched anyways.
Right.
Oh, went for the rolling right kick. That is Huarang's Power Crush move. He has two Power Crushes in this game.
And the thing about his Power Crush is...
Oh, we got Fox Step City.
He's filling himself. Steven is filling himself.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Celebratory taunts. Maybe too soon. Who knows? Oh, again, no just frame there, though. Couldn't punish it.
Oh, you got to point out the bad. You got to point out the bad.
Got to be fair for both. I'm going to shit on both of them. Okay, pressure, but Zhao Yu does have rage. Got to be careful. Oh no, that was a... So after that, I hope that we're able to bring a build of maybe T7FR around the world. I want to make sure everyone gets a chance to get Lord Akuma, try out all the new stuff.
True.
And obviously there's new costumes. They've already announced there's going to be more characters. I'm really excited. Anyways, Joey Fury, Shinblade, here we go. Whose bitch is his? He is...
I if I was in the crowd, I would definitely be willing to put some money on this matchup because Shinblade, as you call it, is a nut. He is crazy, but he knows all his combos. He's also very patient, but he also knows when to pull it out.
Yeah, if you guys remember Shinblade, traditionally using Steve and Nina in Tag 2, am I right?
Yes.
Steve and Nina. Obviously, Lord Nina not in this game. But using Steve instead. And Steve, I believe, is probably the most fun I've had with Steve probably since 5.0.
Really?
I was one of those. I love Steve in 5.0.
I remember you as the Eddie player.
I use everyone. I mean, probably towards the end of the game, I'll stick with one character. But at the start, I will abuse characters Oh, man, this is good stuff right now. So Joe Fury, you guys might remember Tekken 7's, Jack 7 in the earlier versions of Tekken 7 was such a beast. Obviously got normalized
a bit. Oh, yeah, he's a nut.
Oh, man, he just threw out that Shoryu like nothing. Solid combo there. Oh, not today. Oh. You're not stepping on these shoes. Not on my Tims.
But Joey Fury could have killed there if he used the Tekken 7 combo instead of the old T6.
Yeah, he had the Rage Art available, and they just punch each other out. Double KO.
I'm sorry, not can, T6, Tekken Tech 2. Sorry.
Can we get a ref? Oh, man, he caught him pressing buttons. All right, good damage here. Joey Fury with the advantage down the round. That double KO put him up one round away. Oh, that's a new punish there from Steve. 14 frames, does excellent damage, but not safe, of course. Okay, good damage here from Shinblade.
Oh boy, Shinblade aggressive as always.
Joey. All right, here we go. We have the rematch. Looks like we have a new stage. Oh, we are in the open, actually. Again, metal clanging versus the iron fist of the boxing world. Oh, wow. Joey Fury chopping at the ankles right now.
Oh, no punish from the Dutton.
Trying to get some grime on Steve's nice red leather pants here. Oh, wow.
Good step. Wait. This is going to hurt.
This is going to hurt. He gets a nice transition. Oh, he looks like he knows the combos, but unable to convert there on the final hit.
Oh, he's crazy. Watch out. No punish.
Nice. Oh, wow. That's slow motion for me. And again, that's a new thing in Tekken 7. So when both characters are in the red, in rage, and they have the potential to kill, whether it be counter hit or not, or whiff, or whatever, that slow motion will occur. And we've seen some ridiculous examples of that. I'm sure you can find it on YouTube. Oh, man, don't step me. Yeah, I'd be scared of Jack 7 in this game. Look at him. He's laced up. He got some green glow going on. He's on some performance-enhancing stuff, for sure. Nice. Elbow to the noggin, man. Hey, can you still pull off camo pants? Is that a thing?
Yeah.
Is that back now?
Yeah, no, actually, I get my camo pants from Marshalls.
Oh, nice.
They're only $20.
How about the red mohawk?
Red mohawk, well, since I can't grow hair on the top, it's not going to work for me.
Nice. We'll just get a beanie there, red beanie.
But I heard they have man weaves now.
Oh, do they?
They do.
I should look into that. Actually, no, I got flowing hair. I'm good.
Yeah, but you don't have to worry about that.
Oh, nice. He gets the counter hit. Here's the follow-up. Nice. Good follow-up on the combo. Again, there are no walls in this stage. Wow, what an evade there from Shinblade. Now, Shinblade's looking to even it up. Oh, that's not going to do it. Yo, whatever happens, let me throw out down forward two and hit you. Joey Fury, like you said, he's been playing it well. Really interrupting Shinblade's aggressive play style. Oh, down back two, right under his jabs. Oh, and the big boot.
Random big boot.
Oh, what a whiff punish. Two. Is he going to close it out here? There's going to be one mix-up. Debug? No! Oh, man. There's going to be some salt after
such
this.
Such a friendly community we have. Terrorism? What? Oh, guys.
All right, we're going to go on. Here we go. We have multiple tiered floors on this stage, which could lead to huge potential damage. So it's Crowder.
4-4.
Nice.
Four
oh, does not follow up there. Had a good opportunity to get more extension there. Now, I would assume that Cuddlecore is going to use a lot of transitions in AOP to interrupt a lot of Shaheen's beefy moves like 4-1, a lot of the other mid mix-ups.
And both players are being very aggressive right now, too.
Yeah.
Like it's brawling. They came here to fight.
Yes, and Crowder probably realizing now that 4-1 does not hit AOP. All right,
well,
here we go.
4-4 does.
Yeah, it does. Yeah. And he actually has a very strong down forward one poke game, too. Yeah. Complemented by the standing four afterwards. Oh, misses it. And one of the things Shaheen should do after that is the down back two.
Down back two?
Yeah, down back 2-1 if you just want to get a consistent hit. But there are other things. I mean, he could do forward four.
There we go.
Depends on whether or not he uses the
4-1.
All right, so one round apiece. Oh, got the extra hit. Don't be pressing buttons. Downstairs again. Down back two. Yep. And the follow. He did the shimmy.
He did the lead. He did the lead. Fake slide mix up.
He did the pudding pop slide.
Pudding pop slide.
Yep. He was about to slide in. That's why.
Oh. Shout out to Bill Cosby.
All right, here we go. 2-1. Crowder right now. Oh, man. And that is one of the best hop kicks in the game, I feel. I strongly feel.
It's so fast, dog.
Not just that. It just it destroys, like, his virtual hitbox. It just disappears into the air. It's like he's Batman. He just teleports
in. Yeah, it's like it's like the new version of the Lars hop kick.
Yeah, and not as punishable.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. He doesn't get launched afterwards. Unless you catch him out of the air.
12, 14?
Yeah, it's like a general hop kick.
General hop kick.
It's like it's either 12 or 13.
I do not agree with that. That is fucking gross.
Yeah. The best part is he's still got his headpiece on afterwards. He doesn't lose it like, you know, like Jin loses his hood sometimes. Yeah, he knows how to keep his style in. Oh, that's punishable. But it is kind of distance dependent. Oh, nice. Able to get the mix-up. So right now, Crowder looking to sidestep three. Great option there from Cuddlecore. Oh, this is... Oh, no!
What is happening?
Not sure if that was exactly what she wanted for the combo, but it doesn't matter.
Somebody's
got
some nerves. Oh, boy.
And I would be angry. Nope. Yeah, and there's also he's been doing 4-4, the mix-up. That second hit, obviously, it hits grounded. Yeah. So he's, or not grounded, it hits pretty low on the hitbox.
Right, but if she's looking for the first hit,
yeah,
then both strings,
it's so fast.
If you down four, it will kill both of them. You know?
She has to commit, though.
Yeah,
she has to commit.
She definitely has to commit.
It's not one of those, like, let me wait and see.
Yeah,
otherwise, you get bopped.
Yeah, you can't wait and see.
All right, this is going to push towards the wall. Oh, not enough. Oh, while standing 3-3, and that's another move that hits grounded. Okay, and I guess they're just kicking it low. Pressure here. Oh, that's guaranteed.
That's
oh, no, that's not what I would have done. I would have X marks the spot. Probably go downstairs.
Yeah, X marks spot downstairs. Jab down back one.
Yep.
Over. But this game is new.
Or you could even do down back one.
Really?
Yeah, man, it's pretty crazy. Zhao Yu has some stuff. What is that? Storming Flower? Is that what they call it?
Yeah.
All right, good pressure.
Oh, you're talking about 4-4-2-1.
4-4-2-1. I'm sorry, yeah. My bad.
That is
same extension almost, yeah. Oh, again. And we've seen that quite a few times from Crowder already. He's been doing 4-1 into hop kick.
Oh, my goodness.
And that's going to close it out. Even on rounds right now. Nice. That was a good commitment there with the AOP.
Oh, she was a little late on the downstairs extension.
All right, pushing towards the wall. And the follow-up, yes. Downstairs again.
Combo vids.
Probably could have had a little bit more there, but the back four is a great option there with Shaheen.
Telecore being really aggressive, but...
Normal throw.
Joe is making her pay for it with the op kicks.
So we are on potentially the final round here. Let's see if Crowder is able to close it out. But Cuddlecore, I'm sure, is going to put up a fight.
Oh, boy.
All right, down four. Oh, no. Drop the combo.
The nerves are getting to her.
But it doesn't matter. Look at that damage on that AOP 2-1. Oh, he misses the combo. An opportunity here for Cuddlecore. Nice interrupt. Oh, that was a great hesitation there.
She's got the heart of a champion.
AOP
and
duck.
A great scarf. That's a scarf, right?
I gotta look again. But we stylish here in the Midwest. Okay, 4-4 again. Oh, nice. And unfortunately, her upward four does not launch unless it's counter hit. What, does it even launch a counter hit?
Yeah,
it does, right?
Yeah.
Oh, and he's content with just kicking her feet.
Oh, boy. Here we go.
All right, two off axes there to follow up. Oh, that's gonna close it out.
Affected, so we'll see.
He's using Shaheen. He's feeling it. All right, we are in the open stage. There are no walls here.
Sorry, guys. They told me to put the mic close to my mouth. I apologize.
There you go. We can hear you now. All right, nice interrupt into the wild standing four. All right, so Crowder, has been playing pretty safe for the most part. Not really losing to mix-ups. There's the counter hit. Is the follow-up. Does he have the cancel? No, he doesn't. That's one of the things that Shaheen excels in, is getting that extra unscaled damage. And he's just combo potential. But he is low on life right now. He's going to have to be careful. Oh, again, just caught him.
If she had done the down 4-2-1 there, he would have
worked.
But, she got it anyway, so.
Okay. And again, that AOP 4-3. Crowder not reacting to it. I'm guessing he's not really a threat,
like,
right?
He doesn't know what to do right now. Like, he stopped his offense, and he's just reacting.
Yeah. I mean, he has a back four with Shaheen, which is a safe mid-poke that hits grounded.
Really?
I'm not sure why he's not using it. I mean, it works just like Mishima back four, except more consistent on the ground.
Oh, boy. Kanakura looking real strong right here.
Yeah, looking to advance. Oh, wow. He just ducked into hop kick. It works. All right, that's the first time we've seen the up 4-3 really in this matchup as well, and that is a good take on the orbital heel. Okay, great solid damage here. Cuddlecore looking to close it out. Will she be able to do it?
Oh.
Here's a combo opportunity.
Oh.
And one mix-up, good throw break. Combo, if she gets this, she's going on to winner's final. Okay, it's a back turn. Oh, you're not ducking. He probably picked Paul.
Somebody just hated on him, and that's why he's not here.
Yeah. Oh, those leads are good. Let's take him out.
Those haters.
Those capos are really good. Let's take him out.
He made the top eight, but we're not going to let him play.
That's how good he is.
We're a GM hater.
All right, so we have Kazuya versus Leo. I believe the only Mishima here in the top eight, unless you count Jin as a Mishima. I don't.
True.
Yeah. Only Devil Jin.
Yeah.
All right, so here we go. First matchup between these two. Cody with a counter hit, back four, follow up pushing towards the wall into the nice dashing electric combo. Wow, that was good stuff. That was great exhibition of a Mishima combo ability here. Uh-huh, and the follow up. Oh, he misses it. No punish?
Responsible.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, Cody is feeling himself. Let me just do a 4-3. I mean, which is safe for all intents and purposes, but still. Okay. What are you doing, Way Gamble? Isn't that punishable?
Yes.
All right, so he got his gimmick off right to start it off.
I thought he was all about that.
Yeah. Okay, here's the pressure, running three. More pressure. No, I don't think Cody's going to step. I think Cody's just going to play an honest 2D Mishima mix-ups.
2D Mishima's.
Which is pretty damn strong, I think.
True.
Yeah, but if he feels like he'll sidestep electric, oh no, not after that stun.
Like, what was that get-up kick? That animation was foreign
to
me.
It's new. It's the down three. That's the
wake-up down three?
Yeah.
Okay.
From a certain knockdown position.
Okay.
Okay. Oh, I thought he was going to
launch
a tech
streak.
There you go. Wall rising two. This is going to push towards the drop.
Oh, boy.
Oh, great option here. And the mix-up. That is not guaranteed, but it is a pretty damn good option. Low punish? Low jab.
Really?
Damn, that did a lot of damage. Oh! All right, here we go. Let's see if Wade Gamble is able to make some adjustments. I mean, Wade Gamble actually played pretty decently in that matchup. He just got launched a lot.
Yeah.
All right, back four. Nice crouch cancel. Yeah. All right, now the hell sweep's coming out. Oh, you gotta punish that. You got to stop the momentum. You can't let Kazuya get away with that for free. Okay, there you go. At least you went for the low option. But that from crouch down four, 3+4 with Kazuya, not safe.
It's not safe.
It's -10. It's low jab punishable.
So you
get a free low jab.
It.
Yes, you get that free duck jab.
I did not know that.
You might as well do it, right?
That's good to know.
Okay, great stuff here. Wade Gamble finally on the board. Able to take that round. Oh, wow. Went for the power crush. And just like that, life bar dwindling. Okay, back two. Pressure. More stuff. Nice. Now, Wade Gamble hasn't really found the offensive flow. I mean, he won that last round.
He's been back in his heels the whole fight.
Yeah, and you can see the life disparity between these two, right? Cody throwing out all kinds of launchers. I mean, maybe that's a staple for Kazuya, but, I mean, he is controlling the flow of the match for sure. Oh, okay. More pressure from Wade Gamble. I mean, I'd like to see him go low more, maybe. Oh, no.
Oh,
that's not going to work.
Oh, Cody drops the combo.
Okay. Follow up. Oh, no. You better do something.
Oh, that's my hair.
Downstairs.
Oh, and he drops it.
Yeah. Could have had a way better extension if that was one hit into the break. Oh, got so lucky there.
Fighting back.
The wall ended up killing him there.
Nice whiff punish. Gamble with some new vigor, using one of his Tekken Tag 2 strats.
Yeah, I mean, it wasn't looking good for him, but right now he is just one round away from tying it up.
Yeah. Oh, that looked weird. A 4-3 one more time.
Nice. Oh, man, like that. Now Cody coming back, one round away from moving on to the winner's finals.
It looked like Gamble gave away the momentum there. Like, he had momentum and then he backed off. I think he's probably should have stayed pressuring him.
Now who's going to have it? We're going to see either Wei Gamble or Cody.
Oh, boy, that looks scary.
Now how great of a weekend would it be if Cody was able to take both Tekken tournaments?
That would be crazy.
It's looking entirely possible right now.
I know.
But on console, hopefully you guys are all playing.
More girls come to tournaments.
More everything. I want more, well, not bad people, but I want to see more people playing Tekken in general.
Yes. More hot girls come to tournaments, please.
And dudes. We got to balance it, right?
Hey, come on down. I'm progressive.
Nice interrupt there.
That sounded bad. I'm sorry.
It's all good. And to the wall right there. Wei Gamble now playing much more aggressive, and it's working out in his favor. Okay, no punish there. Interesting. Oh, okay. Oh, we are going to keep using that move.
I mean, that's the one thing he told me about the character. He was like, hey, look, this wall standing 4-1+2 is great.
Yeah, it's going to get me to finals.
It's going to get me to the finals.
Yeah, I would have thought it would have been all the accessories he had on that got him into finals.
Oh, yeah, Doug. Hey, he's sponsored by somebody. He should be.
Yeah, at least himself. Oh, man, again.
All this product placement.
You know, I really think he's very confident in that move. He's been using it quite a lot the past two rounds. Oh, man, again. And just like that, Wei Gamble one round away from moving on to winner's finals. Now, Cody's going to have to make some adjustments here. This is great, though. Actually, Wei Gamble changing his entire game plan, being much more aggressive. It's really working out for him. But we'll see. Cody, Kazuya in general, is a punisher.
Yeah, we've definitely seen the tide of battle change because Cody is definitely on his heels now.
No punish there.
And the drop juggle.
Okay. Now, if I'm Wei Gamble, I want to definitely keep the pressure on. Oh, my God. Yeah, I think that was just a delayed reaction. That's definitely punishable by back one with Kazuya. I think.
I would hope so.
There you go. That's punishable on whiff. If you whiff that is definitely punishable.
It looked like he was going for the wild setting 4 to be bait and then catching moving with the 1+2.
Oh, this is going to be scary.
Oh, boy.
This is a bad situation to be.
Oh!
He was greedy. He wanted it.
I don't blame him for going for it there.
Yeah.
You play to win the game.
All right. And again, just like that, Wei Gamble. At the right distance, able to hit that wall standing 4. Get that. Oh, this is going to hurt. That was a free shoulder afterwards, too.
He could have finished the whole thing.
Yeah, he could. Oh, my God.
Oh, power.
The bracket. Loser will be done for the day. Let's see how this turns out. Actually, I'm interested to see this matchup. I wonder how Jack is really going to deal with Shaheen's pressure. Shaheen's pressure is pretty damn safe. So I would have to think Joey's going to have to take some big risks here and there.
Well, from what I've seen of Joey's playstyle, like, he likes to check duck a lot. So if he's looking to check duck the 4-1 or the 4-4, he's going to have to get the wild standing 4 out fast. Or if he guesses right on the 4-1 or the wild standing 1.
Yeah, that's good. I think that's going to be tough. For him to commit and get that wild standing 1, he's going to have to know that it's 4-1 for sure. Oh, wow, he caught him ducking there.
What is that? Is that like a counter hit? Or
that's when forward 3 or stance 3 hits clean. He gets that thing that you see, that's a juggle starter.
Oh, wow. Yeah. When it hits clean?
When it hits clean. It has to hit clean. So if it hits in the air or it hits partially, it's not going to do that weird switch position animation. Okay. So that's why you see that weird animation and they do a little bounce afterwards.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. He gets a pretty strong combo afterwards. It's a nice 60% damage combo.
Oh, wow.
Oh, power crush. Let me get that double back fist into you. Okay. This should be good damage here. To the wall? No, not quite. But fully charged. Whoa!
Oh, wow.
Wow. No,
that was a nice setup, though. He was safe afterwards.
Okay. Good stuff. Now, Jack actually has a punish for most distances against 4-4 with Shaheen. He could do his 4-2 palm.
Or back 1 plus 2 also, right?
What was that?
Back 1 plus 2?
I don't know if he'll... I don't think he'll reach.
That's not
fast enough either.
No. Back 1 plus 2. The one that, like, where he does the little explosion motion and both hands go out, but he goes far.
Isn't that
not
forward
the fast
two?
One? Not the... Not
that oh, one. Oh, the, yeah. The that's forward 1 plus 2.
He's got Steely Reserves. I don't even know what that means.
Steely Reserves? Steel Reserves.
That's a beer.
Yeah.
Oh, man. That's bad.
Already turned. Always turned.
Always turned.
All right. We're here in this Devil's Pit stage. So Joey Fury really has to make some adjustments because right now, Shaheen has been doing work. All right, good pressure. Able to start using forward, forward one now, getting him at the right distance, but he has to be careful. Oh, again, with the power crush.
He took a lot of damage with that power crush, though.
Yeah, but he did get the momentum back.
That's true.
No punish there, and Shaheen for...
What would you punish with, the 4-1?
4-1. Shaheen could do 4-1 for everything.
Okay.
It's like the solution. Nice, Joey Fury on the scoreboard. Hit him on the noggin with that forward, forward one. That elbow haunting him. Okay, here comes the pressure. What's going to happen? Oh, nice duck. Not fast enough to do the punish. You got to really, really commit and do that early. Okay, there's a good punish there from the down forward two. Oh, he tried to go interrupt between it. All right, command grab, good break. Oh, he went for the debugger. That's a good option there. Oh, man, Joey Fury is really going to have to do something. I'd like to see him do some maybe from crouch down back ones. Maybe down 2-1. But we'll see.
Victor.
And they oh, it looked like it was going to be a trade, but down forward one wins it out. So even up right now. Oh, caught him. They trade. Here's a follow-up. Joey Fury's going to get a decent combo here. Pushes towards the wall. And the wall's going to disappear right after this round, so he might as well take advantage of it.
Oh, man. Was that back three, the move that you were talking
it
about?
Was back four. It was back four. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
I didn't see him use it much in this match against Gunnacore, but I've seen him use it more in this match. Maybe he just forgot about it.
Yeah. So now Crowder, with advantage, got him with that 1-2-1 string again. Oh, man. And the grab. What's going to happen afterwards? Oh, again, we're going to grab City. Get in the car. Nice. Get the 4-2 punish there. Oh. No follow-up. Did the wrong kick. You're supposed to do forward, forward, four. Interesting. The old man is out. Probably the
Why
least changed
that,
character. Heihachi's solid in this game. He is very solid. He just has to rely. I mean, he can play him pretty much like tag two. There's some changes. I mean, the second hit of the Hell Sweep, punishable now.
But do you think he has an advantage over Kazuya as far as in this matchup versus Huarong? I really don't know, so.
I would say Kazuya probably has more tools and easier damage if he does get the launch.
That's what I would think, too.
But if you were talking defensively, I think Heihachi's probably a smart pick.
Or maybe it's just that he feels that Speed Kicks is used to playing his Kazuya, so he'll just switch to Heihachi because he can also play him just to throw him off center a little
right. bit.
That's
right. Maybe he has a pocket shittier character.
Hey,
That's a new thing.
That works.
Like,
works.
Let me pick a shittier character.
let me just pick somebody who you're not familiar with me playing. Like.
Yeah. Oh, he goes for the power crush there. Okay. And that pressure looks like Cody's doing a great job right now. He does have a good life lead. There's a ghetto hell sweep.
Ghetto hell sweep.
Back 1-2. Follow up. What's he going to do? Oh, he misses it. Now, another thing that I've seen a lot of Heihachi players do, especially in this game, they do a lot of Hell Sweep 1 because, I mean, obviously Hell Sweep 4 is good, but it doesn't get good damage unless right. you commit to the wall setting 4-4. And
oh,
if you do that,
well
you get launched.
I feel you.
You do Hell Sweep 1, you don't get launched after that. It's
oh,
not
really?
Launch punishable.
Was it negative 14?
I don't know.
I think it's 14.
It's either 14 or 13. But
so you don't get launched by a majority of characters.
Yes.
So yeah. Definitely. If you're going for the low mid, that makes sense.
Yeah.
I've never heard of that. That's good.
Yeah, and it knocks down. You might as well do it, right?
Yeah, might as well. Unless you're fighting like Brian or a good Mishima.
Yes. An on-point Mishima. Or, I mean, you still got to be on point with Brian, too.
Or if, Paul. Paul also.
Oh, I guess shoulder back or three. Back one, two.
No, back three. Back three is 14.
Ah, you're right. Yeah. Back three into juggle. I forgot about that. Oh, good stuff here. So, Cody, man, such a dominating first matchup so far between these two. And you got to see, is the speed kicks have an answer? No, that 4-4-2.
That's kind of broken to me.
It is. It's actually really good. But, I mean,
I don't agree
for a move
that
slow, to, you have to power crush, he's going to eat a lot of hits.
Oh, okay. That makes sense, too.
Yeah.
Because I always forget, because I never really noticed before this weekend that you take damage while you're power crushing. Yeah. I never noticed
it's
that.
Not like Street Fighter. You don't get that life back. Yeah. Boom, counter hit, follow up, nice, sidestep to readjust, he's going to push towards the wall, oh, he goes for that instead, interesting.
I think he was looking for a floor break there, but I'm not even sure if it does break.
There is no floor break, there's a wall break, but it's on the other side.
Okay.
Yeah, that in the far end is breakable.
Yeah, that's what I think he was looking for.
Oh, okay, that's 4-2-3, that is a new move with Heihachi, I think.
I've never seen that.
Either that or it's a move that no one used in Tech 2.
Yeah, I've never seen that before.
Yeah, it's weird, though. It's a not even natural combo.
Oh, really?
It's a very weird string. It's like a, you didn't know about the second part. Boom!
Was it like counter combo, maybe?
The second hit, I believe, does a stun.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah. So it does. That's the purpose, really. Oh, nice. Cody able to get that round. Nice, very clean round from Cody Wu. Oh, neutral hop kick. Nice low jab option. Oh, did not follow up with the launch there. I mean, at the very least, Warren could do while standing three and get some extra follow-up damage.
Uh-oh.
Nice Parabellum kicks. Keeping that pressure on.
Is that what they're called?
Yep. PB kicks. Parabellum kicks.
Parabellum kicks.
If you notice the trajectory of how he's moving his feet when he does it, he makes a nice shape with his
parabola.
Feet. Yep.
What y'all know about parabolas?
What you guys know about geometry and shapes?
What you know about the geometry and shit?
Oh, okay. Good option there from Cody. That down four for the win. Now he's one round away from closing it out, sending speed kicks home.
I was about to say parabola, and I was like, wow, that would make me sound really dumb.
No, you're good. You're good.
Parabolas.
Parabolas.
What's up with the parabolas, though?
Nice launch into the forward. This is a good follow-up. Pushes towards the wall. Not enough, though. Solid option. Nice down forward one. Able to get it. Speed kicks. Looking to turn the tide here. There again, that second hit.
Oh.
Oh, counter hit, interrupt.
Oh, good.
Uh-huh. That's punishable. Wall standing 4-4. Good stuff here. Oh. Whoa, right under. He went for wall standing 1.
This is already doing a lot of damage. Oh.
Now he caught him moving. Oh, tried a neutral hop kick. That was
Or Lars Heihachi.
Nah, nice.
But, yeah, his Lars is good, so. I was thinking we may see some of that in the Tekken 7, but we haven't yet.
Not yet. All right, so Old Man Withers, a.k.a. Heihachi, making a surprise guest appearance here in Tekken 7. I only say that because I very rarely see anyone use them. All right, here we go.
That unibrow, though.
That's power right there. All right. Ooh, nice. Caught him right to the right foot forward transition. And just like that, Cody taking away half of the life and the mix-ups here. Now, Heihachi actually a very, very dangerous character by the walls. And traditionally, he's been that way since they introduced walls into Tekken.
Yeah.
One of the really cool things that I've seen is if he gets a counter hit down one, it'll knock down by the wall, and it guarantees follow-up damage.
Oh, really?
He has a down back two.
But only by the wall, though?
I believe only by the wall it'd be guaranteed, yeah. Good stuff there. He went for the hop over. Ooh! Oh. And a great option and read.
Yeah, I don't
kicks.
Like that. That's pretty cheap, bro.
Hey, man, maybe you could bait him out because, like I said, rolling right kick is high. You bait him out, you duck, and you just punish him and launch him first. But, I mean, you kind of got to get in their head at this point.
Oh, wow.
Perfect.
Do a dance on them.
Speed kicks one round away.
Dab on them folk.
He tried to punish there. All right. Forward, advancing. Pushing towards the wall. Oh! He went for the big combo. That is guaranteed afterwards. Oh, is he going to close it out here? Mix up. Oh. But what he told me was he knows how to fight Shaheen now.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and I think the key to fighting any of the new characters in this game is don't let them get their BS started. Don't let them get their offense started.
You have to be aggressive.
Because think about it. Do you want to rely on your defensive for stuff you don't know or you're not familiar with? Or do you want to lose from your offense?
Right. I prefer to lose from my offense.
Yeah. I don't want to lose the shit I don't know about.
Yeah.
Here we go. All right, good grab and break there from Speed Kicks.
Actually, in this game, I don't know if you can say good break anymore. Just like, oh, yeah.
Actually, yeah, yeah. I guess the most skillful break was if they broke a command throw, right?
Yeah, yeah. It had to be a command throw for it to be a good break.
That's so lame now.
Yeah.
Actually, you know, against certain characters, okay, let's say against Paul. Paul has one of each break.
True.
King has one of each break. So it's actually against those characters, I guess it'd be better.
Yeah. Jin also, I guess.
Yes. But King has always had a very scary break window. I mean, with his running Shining Wizard and his running his running Giant Swing.
Yeah.
Very hard to make out the difference between
definitely
those. And Ghetto Hellsweep really closes it out. So Speed Kicks on a tear right now. Such an such a display of offense there in that last round.
Hashtag counter him.
Oh, man. He is feeling himself. He is going in right now.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Man, Speed Kicks is doing work. Okay, oh, no punish there.
I don't think he knows. He definitely would have if he knew it.
Yeah, he's a robot like that.
Yeah, he is a robot like that.
What's he going to do? I mean, Shaheen is, like, down on life. He's going to have to get some solid damage. And, I mean, with the slide, the best part about the slide is once he starts getting into that motion, he has that crazy hop kick and the orbital heal.
True.
So if he's able to pull out that and really force situations.
Which one is which? Is his hop kick the up 4-3 or up 4-4?
Hop kick is up 4-4. The one where he
and the over the hill is up 4-3?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, we gave y'all that knowledge today. You're welcome.
You're going to learn today.
You're going to learn today. I think my tone was off when I said that. All right, here we go. How about those first Speed Kicks, second game.
Both of these characters very dangerous at this stage. One of the cool things I'd like to see is if they get a floor break, especially from Warang, he could probably do a spike jumping jab into back three, just like unscaled, and does a ton of damage. Especially after a huge combo, that it could really hurt.
Like that stun there from that move, is that breakable or no?
The one from the string?
Yeah, yeah. From the string?
I don't
like
know.
The second hit. Like,
I've never seen anyone break it.
But it looked like a double over stun.
Yeah, it does. It looks like you can break it. It looks like.
Yeah, but when I played Jody yesterday, like he also used the Shaheen, like he hit me with that and I tried to break the stun. I had no success. So
something to
know.
Test. I mean, we'll have Tekken 7 throughout the day still in the corner there. Maybe people will be able to find out. Okay, there he punished it that time.
Okay.
Okay, another punish. Great job from Speed Kicks. Oh, man, he is not giving him any options to start his offense right now. Good stuff. So they're even on rounds right now. Speed Kicks looking to close this out. Okay, pushing towards the wall. That's going to hurt downstairs. Someone just came up to me asking me if someone turned in a set of keys. Does it look like I have people's keys?
Yeah, we are the lost and found people. If someone's wondering.
Two people do a commentary with light shining on them, and you're going to ask them, hey.
If you lost something, come over here, because we have it.
Yeah. Good stuff. All right, back to the match. And he's pulling pressure right now again. Whoa! Nice snake dash into the skyrocket. Downstairs, what's he going to do? Oh, nice. Oh, he pushes towards the wall. That's going to be it. Back three? No. Just right foot forward three. That's all I need.
That's all guaranteed.
And we are on the bottom floor now. There are no more floor breaks. Now, Speed Kicks. If he is able to win this matchup, he will exercise his demon. I mean, this is, again, the man that sent him the losers earlier. Oh, the stop. The disrespect. Oh, man. He's flowing right now. That's over. Oh. That's it.